Morgonpasset i P3, 9:09 är klockan. Vi hänger den här morgonen med Brian Boy, som är en väldigt framgångsrik bloggare och också känd från Top Model på TV. You were telling us that you've been watching some Swedish shows on TV.
Yes, not the Vikings.
Not the Vikings. Actually,
yeah.
No,
but more like Ullared.
Ullared.
I've seen it a few times. Yeah.
And what do you think?
Yeah. It's funny. It's really funny. It's so real. You know. I mean, it's so real.
It is real.
Now it's real, but it's like, I mean, it just, when I was watching, do people really like do all of these crazy things at the supermarket or like they do? Yeah. You know. I love it. It's just like you're glued into it. Yeah. Like, I don't understand Swedish, so, you know, I mean, my knowledge of Swedish is really limited. But just, like, sit there and the visuals, and you see, like, all of these people, I'm just, like, glued into it, you
know?
Yeah, I know. And you asked us, is it really real?
Yeah.
Is it really real?
And it is.
Really?
I didn't know it was a reality show, put it that way.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just, like, torn,
like
you know?
Drama?
No. It's exciting. Anyway.
People eating crayfish, like, sitting there.
Crayfish.
Yeah, like all people.
Keftor.
Ah, yeah.
All the beer.
Yes.
Have you tried crayfish?
I have.
Because it's
in Georgia.
It's the season now. So this is when you
Not in Sweden? You haven't tried it?
No. Well, I've tried it from a, you know, bottled glass.
Oh, okay.
Which is like not like the, you know.
But not the big one.
Not the fresh one. Yeah. Peel them yourself and suck.
Yeah. Oh, suck.
Yes.
Yes. That's what you
do. Like
we call it kräftskiva.
Kräftskiva.
Kräftskiva. It's the name of the party.
Okay.
Everybody wears small hats.
And when is this?
Now.
Now.
Yeah, there's no specific date. It's just like now.
Yeah.
Ish, August,
the end
September.
Of summer. Yeah, all Swedes do the crayfish.
Because then you have one crayfish tail, and then you have a shot, and then you have a crayfish tail, and then you have a shot.
Yeah, you get really drunk.
And then you have a crayfish tail, and then you have a shot.
Oh my God.
Maybe a beer, and then crayfish tail shot. Yeah. That's basically any Swedish tradition. A lot of shots. It's a big part of our culture. Hence Systembolaget.
I mean, Oh my God, I can't do shots. I feel like I'm too old to be, drinking
Nobody
shots.
Nobody can do shots.
Even tequila, like, I mean.
Yeah. It's
I turn into a different person.
But it's always a bad idea.
How do you be? How will you be?
If I'm a tequila, I would, like, always fight. I would always fight
You
people.
Wanna fight?
Yeah, I mean, I'm very aggressive when I'm intoxicated.
You are? Like anybody or just...
Well...
you random, pick your fights or is it just anybody?
I know, I'm just anybody. Anybody who gets in my way, like, I'm just like...
Oh, really? So do you stay away from alcohol or do you...
I mean, I stay away from tequila.
Oh, okay. Good call.
Yeah. Anything else, you know, bring it on. But I have, you know... Yeah.
But you're thinking about getting a dog?
I've been thinking about getting a dog, yes, for the longest time. And I mean, you know, it gets lonely sometimes, you know. And
I want
I
really know
a dog.
She really, really does know.
I really, really do know
better than
how
anyone
lonely
else.
It gets.
Like her and Robinson Crusoe could switch notes.
But now I'm not alone.
Wait. A dog could never replace, you know, a human.
Or could it?
Please
well,
say yes. Please
shopping.
Say yes. No, shop for dogs.
No, but you know, but I really wanted to get a dog so bad, but I travel so much, I'm not sure if it's gonna be practical. Like, where am I gonna leave it? Mm-hmm. But there's a website I discovered this, you know, like a few weeks ago. Have you ever heard of Airbnb?
Where people.
There's this Airbnb for dogs. Mm-hmm. It's like a website with like tens of thousands of people who you can pay to babysit for your dog. It's like dogvacay.com.
Oh, okay.
And you can pay like anyone. It looks like a rental website where you can just like find people to take care of your dogs.
In different cities all over.
Different cities.
Ah, okay.
I mean, there are pictures of like their apartments and what kind of like, you know, it's like it's crazy. Like all for a dog.
I don't know if I'd use, it sounds shady. I don't know if I'd trust it.
Would you ever trust your dog to the hands of another stranger?
No,
I wouldn't
trade if like and they have I have this very nice cellar for your dog. It can be playing in the cellar and we have a very nice there has very nice things we can use on your dog.
Someone who greets you with a whip.
Hello. Wait, sorry. I don't want to give you the wrong impression. We are going to change. We're role playing. It's so weird. This dog will not be a part, I promise.
Oh my God, no.
Don't know I'm German. Can't trust me.
Oh no, I wouldn't leave her.
Yeah.
With a man with a whip.
No, you shouldn't, Hannah. Sjukstugan och Skiz med Zigzag i morgonpasset i P3. Vi hänger med Brian Boy. You'll be staying in Stockholm till Sunday.
Sunday, yes.
And you'll have a lot of fashion shows to attend.
I have about 10, 11 shows. I mean, fashion week here is not really fashion week. It's like 3 days, so
till
it ends tomorrow. Yeah.
So what are you going to do when it's over in Stockholm?
Shop, walk around like a homeless person around Stureplan. No. And then go all the way to Rinkeby and then like meet my homies and my friends there. No, I'm kidding. I'm
just, like, really know Stockholm.
I mean, I don't know everything, but I love Stockholm. I mean, if, you know, it's a place that I love so much and I just like to explore, you know. So I'll be exploring around. I'll take pictures. I'll hang out. Swedish summer is the best.
Yeah. You
know? Word.
I was here, you know, in the winter time 2 years ago and minus 25.
Yeah.
I went to Flottsbro, took pictures naked, nothing but my underwear.
Flottsbrobacken, it's in the south of Stockholm. I used to live around there.
Oh, okay.
Flottsbrobacken.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I went there, took pictures in the snow, like my underwear, minus 20. And then
why?
It's a hard work being a fashion blogger.
It sounds like it. Hard
so how
work.
Do you earn your money?
Is advertising.
Advertising.
Advertising, you know, appearances, special projects. Like I would like, you know, judge for a contest, for example. Mm-hmm. And then just like, you know, a lot of like advertising.
Do you ever get tired of going to fashion shows?
No. It's always like something new to see. And then, you know, I mean, it's worth going to so many shows, even though like some of them are like, you know, the same, because if you see something really good and really special, at least you are there to see it.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, even if like you see shows, you know, online, on a video, on a TV or in pictures, it will never replicate the same thing that you see in real life, because in real life, you can see the fabric, you can see everything, you know.
Yeah.
But can you ever feel like, are there ever trends in fashion shows? Like this year, there's a lot of
music. I mean,
music
it's all coincidental. It's all coincidental. Nobody's, you know, going to be like, oh, okay, these are like, you know, this is what we should be doing. I mean, of course, trends come from fabrics, you know, from like, you know, the fabric suppliers pretty much. But trends are just like made by editors, made by the media, made by the press to kind of sell something. So I don't believe in trends. I believe in personal style more.
Because you know? I've always wondered who sets the trends.
Nobody does. The magazines do. It's just like they create all of these, you know, trends as opposed to like the designers. The designers just do whatever they want to do, you know?
Yeah.
Do you have like a favorite Swedish designer?
Acne is my favorite.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah. Public service.
A lot of other Swedish.
Sorry, står inte bakom Brian Boys uttalande. Det står för honom.
Ja.
Word!
Safe. Men förlåt, jag har haft sommarlov, granskningsnämnden.
I'm sorry. We have to.
Yeah,
this is public service. Men vi frågade honom, herregud.
Ja, men han är ju en modebloggare. Ja, då är det väl intressant att veta om man har någon favorit på svenska marknaden.
Verkligen. Jag tycker det var en bra fråga. I'm sorry.
I love how you can like curse but not like promote a brand.
It's sick.
Yeah,
it is.
But it's not really promoting. It's more of like, you know, what your personal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, I'm not promoting anything.
Yeah,
I'm promoting
myself.
Yeah,
very good.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Next
question.
But okay, but do you ever get invites to like fashion shows you don't want to go to? Do you have to go to everything?
Oh, all the time. I mean, it's not a matter of like, I mean, people invite me because, you know, they want me there, they want me to cover their show, but, you know, I cannot do it all, you know. I try to go to the ones I love, you know, that I have a connection with, that I find interesting. Sometimes I would support a young designer. It's very important to support young designers, you know, as opposed to just only going to the big shows.
Mm-hmm.
It's really a mix and match. Sometimes I'm like late, you know, even if I wanted to go to like one show, but I'm like late, I'm coming from downtown, you know, I'm going to Uptown, for example, in New York, like there's a show every hour. If I'm late, then I'm just gonna like not skip it. I mean, I'm just gonna skip it, you know.
Yeah. But have you ever had like, you don't have to say who, but have you ever had a beef with a fashion designer?
Never.
Who's been like, I read your blog and I don't appreciate.
No, never. Never.
They never like held a knife to your throat and like, listen, motherfucker, you better not write this shit about
Maybe
me.
Maybe not a knife, but they held a gun. No, I'm kidding. No, never.
I just saw my eyes. Hard work.
Mark Jacobs is an alcoholic.
I never, don't twist my words. I never said that. Never.
Apparently,
never.
He carries guns too.
No.
We're joking.
No.
But do you ever get tired of vlogging?
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Because I don't have the, you know, the time to just sit down. I mean, you know, I try to live my life as opposed to like living my life for the blog. You mm-hmm. know, yeah. I mean, I live my life so I can blog. I mean, you know, and share it selectively. But I mean, it came to the point sometimes where I'm like just doing so much and I cannot just like, you know, sit down there. But no, I mean, sometimes it gets tiring because you have to like, you know, be responsible to people and not yeah. really be your full self. I mean, when I started blogging, like my pictures, like, oh, I'm gonna post pictures of me drunk. I'm very transparent. I tell everything. But now I'm like, I have 10-year-olds from Norway reading me. Yeah. I gotta post a picture of me smoking a cigarette. I mean, I gotta post a picture of me holding, like, you know, like a wine glass, like
yeah,
or a dead rabbit.
But what?
I'm gonna wear you as a hat.
What are your future plans, though?
Future plans?
Yeah.
Get married, get pregnant, have a dog, and have a car.
Oh, there's love plans as well.
Yeah.
That's the Swedish dream.
It was halfway there.
No, but are you going to start like Brian Boy TV? Or...
No. I mean, it's too early. Blogging? It's too early. I mean, you know, even with the whole blogging phenomenon, it's still new. Like, mm-hmm. nobody knows where it's going to go, but... I just want to, like, you know, do something for myself, expand my brand. You know, I mean, I'm working on collaborations now, like, on merchandise. I mean, I have my fur accessories. And I just, like, want to explore merchandising more and, you know, explore media more, you know, mm-hmm. write a book.
Yeah.
Write a book.
Yeah.
About what?
About myself.
Of course.
No, about fiction. You know, I mean, I want to create, like, a fiction series, you know, for, like, young adults. And
but are we talking, like, Twilight or...
No, more like Sweet Valley High.
Wow!
Have you ever heard of Sweet Valley?
Yeah, yeah. Wow! Really?
Sweet Valley.
I haven't thought of that show in years.
Elizabeth and Jessica Wakefield and Lila Fowler. I know.
Brian, thank you so much for visiting with us.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you. Thank you. Pumping Blood.
Jag säger bara så här.
Ja.
Kokain och tjursperma. Resten får ni veta sen. Cliffhanger much.
Bra tis.
Yes.
Och det slår mig att det var typ det första du sa i morse också.
Kokain och tjursperma.
Ja, de två orden var det första som kom över dina läppar den här morgonen.
Det fanns en matnyttig och så här intressant artikel.
Ja.
Men sen såg jag kokain och tjursperma och kände nej.
Ja, det var då jag avbröt dig för min skåphistoria.
Han bara, vänta! Jag har två grejer från mitt liv! Kanske tre!
Kokasmin!
Vänta! Det var ett skåp. Så vidare.
Ni var där när det hände. Klockorna stannade, ni minns.
The Mother We Share i morgonpasset i P3. Eftersom klockan närmar sig 9 med stormsteg så är det dags för mig att bolla över till Simon på P3 Nyheter.
Ja, det får du gärna göra. Det ska handla om Ryanair-piloter som har tröttnat på kassa arbetsförhållanden och startat ett anonymt facknätverk. Och dansklubb i Örebro säger nej till samkönade par. Och så om en drive-in sex premiär. Klockan är 9. P3. Men först ska vi berätta att en död man har hittats i hamnbassängen i Malmö nu på morgonen. Dykare hämtade upp kroppen och nu ska polisen utreda om det ligger något brott bakom. Branden i vårdboendet i Norrtälje som började brinna i natt är fortfarande inte helt släckt. Huset är totalförstört och räddningstjänsten misstänker att tre personer kan ha omkommit. I somras fick flera kommuner kritik för att de sparar känslig information i molntjänster på nätet. Och nu kan P3 Nyheter berätta att forskare på flera universitet gör samma sak. Erik Jansson på Datainspektionen varnar för att informationen kan spridas och användas till något helt annat än det var tänkt.
Ja, den största risken är att de här uppgifterna då som har lämnats ut bara för att användas för visst forskningsändamål sprids till helt andra okända underleverantörer till Dropbox och liknande kan man fråga om och börjar användas för helt andra ändamål.
Läs mer om det på vår sajt. Nu har Ryanair-piloter tröttnat och startat ett anonymt nätverk för att driva sina fackliga frågor. Så här berättar en av piloterna och hans röst är utbytt eftersom piloterna som engagerar sig fackligt är rädda att få sparken.
Ryanairs ledning kallar vårt nätverk för anonyma internettroll. Ryanair lyckades också stänga ner vår Facebook- och Twitter-sida. Idag har de öppnats igen. Det tunga är att man inte känner någon säkerhet i sitt arbete, att de kör med skrämseltaktik.
Ryanairs piloter har kritiserat företaget för att de flyger för långa pass. För att de aldrig vet hur länge de ska vara stationerade på sin bas. För att de bor i ett land och skattar i ett annat. För att man är rädd att förlora jobbet om man är sjuk. Frågor som det röstas om i deras nätverk. och som de kommer att driva gentemot arbetsgivaren, fortfarande anonymt via brev med avsändaren RPG eller via juridiska ombud. Anders Kjellgren är ansvarigt ombud för de piloter från Ryanair som vill vara anslutna till Svensk Pilotförening.
Ur ett faktiskt perspektiv så är det ju helt förkastligt att man år 2013 faktiskt måste hålla sig anonym när det faktiskt är en rättighet i svensk lagstiftning att kunna organisera sig och vara medlem i ett fackförbund.
Reporter här var Susanna Einerstam. Samkönade par får inte vara med och dansa bugg hos en dansklubb i Örebro. Klubben är orolig för vad andra dansare ska tycka om att de får dansa med någon av samma kön, eftersom man ju byter partner under dansen. Det har i och för sig aldrig kommit någon sån kritik tidigare, och klubben säger till NA.se att det kanske är dags att se över det där beslutet igen. Och nu om en lite annorlunda typ av drive-in. Hugo Renius berättar mer.
Nu har en verksamhet med drive-in till sextjänster öppnat i Schweiz. Syftet är att skapa en tryggare miljö för sexarbetare i Zürich och för att få bort prostitutionen från gatorna. Systemet funkar så att kunderna kör upp och parkerar bredvid en sexbox där man gör upp om priset. Sen används en typ av parkeringsmätare för att hålla koll på tiden. De prostituerade får också bidra med en kostnad för att få jobba på anläggningen som har plats för ungefär 50 arbetare. Igår hölls invigningen som skedde tillsammans med en stor fanfar och många journalister. Men bara några få kunder, rapporterar TT.
Det ser ut att bli en solig dag i Götaland, Svealand och södra Norrland. I norra Norrland däremot så får Lappland mycket moln och kanske lite regn. Men det finns ganska bra solchanser österut. Temperaturen den hamnar på omkring 20 grader. Och med det sätter vi punkt för P3 Nyheter. Klockan 9. Vi är tillbaka igen om en timme. Stanna kvar du och lyssna på Morgonpasset.
Det här är P3.
Sveriges Radio.
Vi älskar ny musik.